Namaste yogis, welcome to day 20. Today we are working on the side body, lengthening it, giving it more space. And before with that, we're going to start with a short meditation. So sit comfortably in a cross-legged seat, close your eyes, let go of shoulders, of your belly muscles, just let it relax. And sink with your pelvis into the floor, into the mat. Become heavy. And close your eyes, observe your breath. Relax your legs and observe where your legs or feet touch the floor. With the next inhale, lengthen your spine, your neck, lifting through the crown of the head. And observe your breath, the in and the out of the breath. Observe the sounds around you. With your attention, come to your skin. Notice the temperature of your skin. And take a deep inhale through your nose. Open your mouth and let it go. Two more. Inhale. And let go. Next time. Inhale. Sit very consciously, lengthen the side body. And let go again. From here, bring your right fingertips down, left arm comes up, and lean towards your right side, opening the left side in an easy stretch. Keep your shoulder blades down, keep some space between your ears and your shoulders. And also rest your elbow down. Keep your left hips down as well. And breathe deeply. Maybe look up underneath your left arm. Inhale, come back up. Bring your left hand on your right knee. And bring your right fingertips behind you. Lengthen your spine. Inhale. And exhale, twist. Easy twist, not too much yet. Keep both sides of your side body long. And an inhale, come back. Left fingertips come down, right arm up, inhale. Lengthen your side body on the right side and lean to the left. Make sure you're not lifting your hips. Keep your hips well connected with the floor and look underneath your right arm. Shoulders down and keep on breathing. Deep inhale and exhale through the nose. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, come up. Bring your right hand on top of your left knee, left fingertips behind you. Straighten the spine, inhale, lengthen, and exhale, twist. Again, in. And out. One more, inhale. And exhale, come back to center, come to all fours. And we are starting with Anahata Asana. So bring your hands a little bit forward, arms are straight, hips over knees, and then sink. Maybe you want to adjust. You don't want to have your knees here, and then sink into Balasana. Keep your knees underneath your hips, so you're kind of in a right angle. Inhale, both arms are straight. Upper arm turn outward and then sink your chest between your arms and let your forehead go to the ground. If it doesn't touch the ground, take a block underneath your forehead. If you feel you want a little bit more of a stretch, prop your chin up and look forward. Keep your arms straight, keep your hands well connected with the mat. And breathe. Take your variation and stay here for just a couple of breaths.
In and out. Melting your chest towards the floor. Pushing your hands down. Your arms stay straight. And deep breaths. Widening the ribcage. And exhaling, closing the ribcage and sinking and melting. Then gently push through your hands, come back to all fours, place your hands widely spread underneath your shoulders, your knees underneath your hips, tuck your toes, inhale, cat cow, inhale, chest forward, shoulders back, and exhale, round your back, cat. Really pushing the floor, inhale, lift your chest, and exhale, pushing the floor and rounding the back. Inhale, a couple of rounds here to wake up the spine, to wake up the side body as well. Exhale. Keep breathing through your nose. And exhale, pull your navel back, round your back, push your hands down. And inhale, last one. And exhale. And from here, maybe you want to adjust your hands, tuck your toes and push your hips back and up into your first down dog. Walk your dog. Lengthen your calf muscles. And look forward, walk your feet forward, step by step between your hands. You might want to keep a belt ready if your shoulders are not opening easily. Inhale, lengthen the spine, and exhale, fold. Now hold the opposite elbow, let your head go, keep a nice little bend in your knees, and let yourself hang, lengthening the spine, lengthening the side body, maybe swaying from side to side. If you're more comfortable, you could also straighten the legs. And then exhale, let go of your hands, bring your fold in behind you, interlace your fingers. If that's difficult, grab a belt and pull the belt apart. Inhale, lift up, and exhale, fold. And breathe. With or without belt, fold your, interlace your fingers, clasp your hands. Bring the palms together if that's possible and move the shoulders away from your ears, let your head hang. Keep a nice little bend in your knees and breathe. Now pull your hands towards the right and open up your left side and breathe. Keep your left leg straight and your right leg slightly bent. Deep breaths. Inhale, come back to center. Switch sides, bring your hands towards the left. Straighten the right leg, bend your left, and breathe. And then come back to center. Let go of your arms and come up into Utkatasana. And exhale, come to standing. Hands in front of the chest. Notice your feet. Notice your legs pushing down through the outer edges of your feet. Pull your belly in. Send your hip bones, your hip down, your tailbone down. Shoulders are relaxed. And then release your arms. Again, Utkatasana, sweep your arms up, inhale. And exhale, fold forward into Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, step back into downward facing dog.
keep your feet almost mat width apart. Bend your knees and maybe step a little forward. Bend your knees if needed. Then place your right hand into the middle of the mat. Take your left hand on the other side of your right ankle and twist. Pull, you see, really pull yourself toward underneath. Look underneath your right arm, pull yourself with a long spine. And breathe. Inhale, come back to center. Place your left hand down. Switch sides, right hand grabs the left ankle or maybe above the ankle on the shin and come to a twist. Make sure your hips don't move to the left. Keep your hips centered and breathe. Push through the left hand. Inhale, come back to center. Place your hands for downward facing dog. And then come to your knees and Balasana, child's pose. Arms are straight, come to your fingertips. Outer arms roll outside. And lift your head, inhale. And then walk your hands towards the right. Keep your hips connected with your heels. And give yourself a nice stretch on the left side body. And inhale, come back through center, walk through the other side and sit down firmly onto your heels. Open up your right side, the right side body. And breathe deeply. And inhale, come back through center and come back into downward facing dog. Bend your knees, look forward, step between your hands. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold in. Push your feet down, lift up. Urdhvastasana. And then interlace your fingers. And bring your index fingers up. Place the palms together, so you're actually in a mudra, Kali mudra. Inhale, and on the exhale, lean to the right, open up, keep your belly active, and only come as far as you keep both feet really firmly on the floor. Inhale, come up, and exhale to the other side, lengthening both sides of your body, of your torso. Inhale, come up. Exhale, hands down, sweep forward into Uttanasana. Inhale to lengthen. And exhale, step back into plank pose. Make sure you push through your heels. Your belly is firm, shoulders back, look forward and down. And breathe. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, knees come down. Exhale, all the body comes down. Then bring your hands a little bit on shoulder height. I'll come onto your fingertips. Straighten both feet. Inhale, roll your shoulders back and come up. Look forward, shoulders stay down. You can also bend your elbows if it's a little bit too much or change the position of your hands. If you feel a pain in your lower back, come down a bit. Look over your right shoulder towards your right foot. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, look over your left shoulder. Look back. And exhale, come all the way down. Place your hands underneath your shoulders. Tuck your toes. Push back into downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg rises up and back. Bend your knee. and open up your hip. Keep both sides of the torso the same length. Don't sink into your right chest. Keep your right chest up. Push through your hands. Inhale. Exhale, bring your left knee into your chest. Bring your shoulders over your wrists and come back. Open up your hip and bring up your knee. Exhale, bring your left knee in. And now step it through. And turn your right foot, come up into Warrior Two. Find a position of the feet. Right leg is straight. Right foot 45 degrees, left foot looks forward. Then bring your tailbone down. Feel the stretch in your right side, the right groin. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Feel the stretch in the left side of your body. And breathe. Keep your shoulders down, keep your belly button in. And exhale, either bring your left elbow on top of your left knee or your left fingertips down onto the floor or the hand on the block. Then bring your right arm up, turn your palm, open up the chest and bring your right arm over your ear. Make sure you're not shrugging or you're not lumping, coming forward. Keep this opening, turning of the chest active. Keep pushing down through the outer edge of your right foot. Or try to keep the arches open and lifted. Inhale, come up. Warrior Two. Reverse your warrior and start straightening your left leg. Opening up your left side. And breathe. Inhale, come back to center. Lean forward and come to Trikonasana, left hand on left shin, or further down, bring your right arm up, turn your torso, and shoulders roll back. Feel the stretch on your inner left thigh, and look down, exhale, bend your knee, bring your right hand onto your hip, and from here we come to Ardha Chakrasana. So bring the weight into your left standing foot and lift your right leg up. You can use a block on your left, underneath your left hand, or come to your fingertips and start turning the torso, lengthening both sides of the body, both sides of the side body. And then bring your right arm up. Flex your right foot, right leg is super straight. Left leg could be bent or straight. And then like a star, just move into all the directions. Exhale, look down. And bring your right leg back. Come back into Warrior Two. Wiggle your hands down. Place your hands, turn your right foot. And lift your left leg. And from here we come to plank with a lifted left leg. Come forward until your shoulders are above your hands. And exhale, come all the way down. Straighten your feet. Lift up into cobra. And exhale, down dog. Other side, right leg lifts. Bend your knee, open the hip. Lifting your left chest. And breathe deeply. Exhale, bring your right knee into your chest, your shoulders over your wrists. Lift your left, the right knee. Inhale, come back up and open up again. And breathe. Exhale, bring your right knee in. And step it through. Turn your left foot, come up into Warrior Two. Breathe. Inhale, reverse your warrior. Right knee stays bent. You can also go a little deeper, but it might adjust your knee, your position of the foot. Shoulders stay down. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, either right arm on right elbow on right knee, push it out, or bring your right fingertips down or in a block, and lift your left arm and over your ear. And breathe. Inhale, come back up. Warrior two. And reverse your warrior. Straighten the front leg and lean back with the belly active. And then exhale, lean forward with your right arm. And set your right hand on your shin, turn your torso. Left arm lifts and come into Trikonasana pose. Come only as far down as you feel you can stay with a turned torso. You don't want to lean forward and come all the way down. Lift it up a bit and turn. And then look down. Bend your knee from here to Ardha Chandrasana, either with a block or come into your fingertips. Left hand onto your hip, open your hip. Flex your left foot. Left leg is straight. And then pull up left arm and maybe look up. And breathe. Exhale. Turn down and bring your left, no, and step it back into warrior two. Sorry for the mix up. And release down, bring your right leg up. And with a lifted right leg, come forward into plank and lower down. Stretch your feet, lift up into cobra, inhale, long sides, and exhale, downward facing dog. And breathe. Hello, cat. And from here, chase away the cat. And take two steps between your hands, lift up, inhale, and exhale, fold in. Push the floor, lift up, Urdhva Hastasana, and exhale, hands in front of your chest, and breathe. And then lift your arms up slowly and lift your heels up. Stay, long side body, strong belly. And bring your hands in front of your chest and start bending your knees on your tippy toes and come down. Slowly. And then sit back. And come into Navasana. Stretch your feet if you want to. Chest open. And exhale. Bring your knees in. Make a little bundle. Your neck shuts. And then roll up into standing. Three times. Cross your ankles and shift your feet back into downward facing dog. Lift your left leg up. And exhale, bring your left foot between your hands, turn your right foot for you too. Come on. And stretch your front leg, turn your left foot. Interlace your hands behind your back again, or grab the belt. Inhale, lift your chest, And exhale, lean forward and breathe. Make sure you're pulling your feet, the outer edges of the feet are pushing down, and now you're pulling your feet almost like putting them together, hug them in. Shoulders roll away from your ears. And let go of your hands, push through your feet, come up with a straight back. Into standing, release your arms. Now turn your feet upward, come sink into your hips, and come into a goddess pose. And sink deep. Then bring your right elbow on top of your right knee, and lean over to the side, push your right knee backwards, and lean over, opening your left side again. Inhale, come back up, switch sides, left arm pushes your knee out, right arm comes up and you lean over. If you start shaking a bit, it's okay. Inhale, come back up into goddess pose and exhale, hands in front of your chest. Turn your feet forward and come down, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward, since the cat is gone, jump forward, cross your ankles, and sit back into Navasana pose. And breathe. And then exhale, lower yourself down, spread your toes, look at your toes, hold. And breathe. And then exhale, slowly come down. Place your feet in front of your seat and come into bridge pose. Palms are facing down. Inhale, lift your chest, push into your elbows and hands, and then push into your feet. Exhaling, lift your hips. Stay here if your shoulders are tighter, or interlace your fingers and roll your shoulders under. And breathe. Release. Come all the way down. Grab underneath your hips, underneath your knees. And again, roll up. This time into a seated position. Take your left foot out. And your right knee is bent, bring your right foot into your left thigh. And then from here, with your left hand, grab your knee. Inhale the right arm up, and then lean over. Doesn't have to go deep. If that's too much, bring your left hand parallel to your left leg, and lean over, opening your chest. And inhale, come back up. Bring your right hand behind you. Place your right foot so it touches the ground. Then come to your right knee. Lift up, lift your hips up, and stretch your left arm back. Give yourself a nice stretch to your left side, the left groin, even the right groin you might feel. And breathe. Exhale, come all the way down. And then switch sides. Stretch out your right leg. Left foot comes into your left thigh. Yes. And then bring your right hand on top of your left knee. Or as you had it before, parallel, the underarm parallel to your right shin. And then inhale your left arm up. And then lean over. Choose your variation. It could be here, it's easier to lean down, but the result mustn't be touching your toes, Just opening your side body. Keep your right foot flexed, toes coming towards your face, your head. And then again, one more deep inhale. Exhale, come up, bring your right hand behind you. Turn your right foot, your left hand behind you. Your right foot comes down and then push through your knee and your foot. Lift your hip up, bring your right arm up and give yourself a nice stretch. Right leg stays straight. Make sure your hand is underneath your shoulder and come down. Sit down. Sit forward for Paschimottanasana. You might need a belt for this. And maybe you want to sit on a blanket. So you can sit upright. You don't want to round your back yet. Lift your chest up and wrap the belt around the tops of your feet. If you can't reach your toes. And without shrugging your shoulders, lift your chest. And pull yourself very gently forward. Just it's more like a guidance than a pulling action. Rest here 45 degrees. Get your body used to the stretch. Maybe you feel the stretch in your hamstrings. Maybe that's enough. If you don't have a belt, you can just walk your fingers forward. And if you can, don't force it. Wrap your hands around your feet. If that's too little still, you can grab a block or grab your wrist, the right hand grabbing your left wrist or the other way around, and then folding forward into Paschimottanasana. Also thinking of your side body, lengthening the side body. Breathing, giving yourself time to open up. And as I said, if it's too much, just go one step back. You don't want to tear anything. You don't want to end this session injured. You want to feel the stretch, but no pain. And then inhale slowly, come back up. And then bend your knees. And from here, on the other side, kitty cat. So stretch your legs and come to into a Shavasana pose. Inhale, collect all the energy in your center line, like that runs in the middle of your body. Inhale, then firm up all the muscles in your face, in your body. Even cramp the hands, maybe cramp the feet. And on the exhale, let go. From the center, relax out. Melt into the mat. Keep your palms facing up, very relaxed. Keep on breathing softly. Give yourself the time of releasing. Stay here for a little longer if you'd like to, and come back to a seated position later on. Just take your time for both. Start wiggling your hands, your fingers, your toes, bring your knees in. Roll to the right side and come back to a seated position, slowly, in your own time. Come back to a cross-legged seat. Bring your hands lightly on your knees. Lengthen again the side body. Lengthen through the spine. Become heavy in your hips and your seat. Once you're settled in this upright position, take your right hand up, fold your index finger and middle finger down into the ball of your thumb. If that's really hard to do, bring your both of these fingers between your eyebrows. And then inhale and exhale. Close your right nostril with your thumb. Inhale through your left nostril. You don't have to press hard, just keep your left right nostril closed. Then close your left nostril with your ring finger and exhale through the right. Open up your right nostril. Inhale through the right. Close right, exhale left. Inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Inhale. Right, exhale left. Keep your shoulders relaxed. Make inhale and exhale the same length. Inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Inhale right. Close right, exhale left. And let your right hand sink. And feel the effect of these calming breathing technique. Again, relax your face, relax all the muscles in your face. And like with an inner smile, fold your hands in front of your chest. Aware of your long spine and your firm seat and base. Bow. Namaste. Thank you for practicing. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I hope it was good for you today, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.